I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and in this video, I'm gonna give you my experience using Tresiba and Levemir, two different long-acting insulins. Before I get into my experience with Tresiba and Levemir, let's just talk a little bit about insulin. Insulin is a hormone that all humans need. It's a hormone that helps transport energy. So when we eat, the energy gets turned into glucose and it goes into our bloodstream. Insulin is a hormone that transports it from the bloodstream and into our cells. It keeps us alive. It keeps our body fed. So if you live with insulin dependent diabetes like me, you need to inject this insulin yourself. So there's different ways of doing that. I use insulin pens. So I am on MDI, multiple daily injections. That means that I inject both a basal insulin, which is Tresiba and Levemir, they're basal insulins, and I inject a rapid acting insulin for like meals and corrections. So those long acting insulin or basal insulins are the ones that we take maybe once or twice a day, and that's a background insulin. It's an insulin that makes sure that our brain and our bodies are fed throughout the day, it takes care of hormones, etc. So it's usually a longer acting. They last from everything from 12 hours to 42 hours in the body. There are a lot of basal or long-acting options available to us living with insulin-dependent diabetes. But today I'm going to focus on Tresiba and Levemir and my personal experience, what I like about those two products, and why I have ultimately now switched over to Tresiba. I started using Levemir. Let me show you this. This is Levemir. I'll take it out of the pack. So it comes with 5 pens in a pack if you buy the pre-filled pens. So this is a pen. See, the insulin is in here. And you just screw on a needle and you use it. But I started to use this product, this long-acting insulin, back in 2005. So that was when it first came to market. That's, what, 15 years ago? And its generic name is insulindenamir, and it is manufactured by Novo Nordisk. So the way that works is, well, you put on the needle and inject your insulin, and it starts to become active in the body after 1 to 3 hours. It does have a bit of a peak, so that peak is generally after 8 hours, and the product will be, and the insulin will be active in your body for up to 24 hours. So let me just, I pulled up their pharmacodynamics, so let's just put it up here and look at that for a second. So that basically shows you, after injected, how the product generally works in the body. I generally liked using Levemir as my basal insulin. That's why I used it for 15 years. For me, however, only taking once a day didn't really work, and I generally would metabolize it faster than 24 hours. So I did take the insulin twice. I would take it in the morning as well as in the evening. So before I stopped this product, I was taking 17 units in the morning and 4 units in the evening. So not a 50-50 split. For me, if I would split it 50-50, I would go low at night. So that's why I took more in the morning and less at night. I did get pretty good diabetes management using this product. However, I would still see an increase in the morning, both from dawn phenomena, which is like 3 to 5 a.m. insulin blood sugar increase, as well in the morning when I woke up. So for me, it was a question of, given that this product does have a peak after 8 hours, I would try to time it so that my evening dose would be like around 11 p.m. so that the product would peak around, you know, we're gonna say 7 a.m. in the morning. That worked fairly well. But it also meant, given that I do metabolize this product fairly quickly, is that if I missed a dose, I would start to see high blood sugars very fast. I would also say that given it does have a peak after those 7 to 8 hours, you have to be very careful with your timing. You don't want it, if you, like most of us, tend to see a blood sugar drop around 3 a.m., you don't want to time the insulin so that you take your evening dose so that it peaks at 3 a.m. What I really, really liked about Levemir, though, is actually that I was taking it in the morning and again in the evening. That meant I had a lot of flexibility. Given that insulin was only active in my body maybe 12, 14 hours, I could change my basal up fairly often. So meaning that if I would have a day where I knew I was going to be very active, I could dial down my morning insulin dose and have less basal insulin going, and then again take my normal dose at night if I needed to, or if I go through periods, and I do when go through periods where I eat more and more carbohydrate heavy diet, for those periods of time I might need a little bit more background insulin because there'll be more glucose stored in my muscles and in my liver. So really, really cool thing about Levemir is the flexibility. The downside is, well, you do have to take maybe up to 2 doses, and it does have that peak. So this is Tresiba. So this is the long-acting insulin I'm using now. Let me take that out. Also comes with 5 pens in a pack if you do get the pre-filled pens. Same deal as the Levemir. The insulin is already in here. I click on my needle, but that's about the only things that, you know, are the same with Levemir and Tresiba. So Tresiba, its generic name is insulin degludec, and it's also manufactured by Novo Nordisk. It will start to work. So once you inject it, it will start to work in the body already after 1 to 2 hours. It does not have a peak, so it has a flatter profile, and it can last all the way up to 42 hours in the body. So it's a much longer acting insulin. Again, let's pull up the pharmacodynamics so you can see that up here. And you can also find this on the manufacturer's website. I switched from Levemir to Tresiba on November 26, 2020. And I talked to my endocrinologist and we agreed that I would just do the same dose that I was doing with Levemir, our former Tresiba. So I was doing 17 units in the morning and 4 units at night. With Levemir, says 21 units. So I took 21 units in the morning of Tresiba. And that just turned out to be way too much for me. So I would say that if you switch to Tresiba from something like Levemir or another long-acting insulin, have a titration plan. So that simply means talk to your endocrinologist or whoever helps you manage your diabetes about, well, what if this dose is not right for me? How long do I stick with it before changing? And when do I, how much do I change it by? So I'm self-managed. So I would go two to three days on one dose before making changes. And that also means it took me 2 weeks to get to the right titration because I ended up at that period of time only needing 12 units in the morning. That took some time, so that was a lot of lows, but it was worth it for me to find the right dose. I now go between 12 units and 17 units of a Tresiba. And I just, since I'm self-managed, I just, you know, titrate it up and down depending on what's going on in my life. So again, I started out with 1 dose. What I have found is that I do need 2 doses of Tresiba, both in the morning and the evening, for periods of time where I might not be as active or where I eat a more carbohydrate heavy diet. So that's just what I found works best for my body. You obviously need to work with your medical team figuring out what works best for you. I would say one of the coolest thing about Tresiba is the flat profile. So remember, as I said, it has a flatter profile and lasts up to 42 hours in the body. That means that I am not battling dawn phenomena anymore. So dawn phenomena is when your blood sugars will start to rise around 3 to 5 a.m. in the morning due to glucose release from the liver. Same thing with the morning rise. A lot of us, when we wake up, sort of feet on the floor, we'll see a blood sugar increase. I don't have that anymore due to Tresiba. So that's pretty cool. I also have some really, really beautiful flat lines because there's no peak. So I can be like coasting all night with a completely flat line. So that is very exciting. Also, exercise on Tresiba only is pretty amazing. I can go for long hikes. And if I don't have any IOBs, active insulin on board from my rapid acting insulin, I will just be completely flat. So that's a huge upside, I would say. The one downside I would say there is to Tresiba is that it can last up to 42 hours in the body. That does mean it's hard to make changes because, you know, once the insulin is injected, it's injected. I expected it to be an issue from days where I'm very active versus days where I'm not as active, but I haven't really found that to be an issue. There will be some days where I do need more insulin, but often I can take care of it with my rapid acting insulin. So in conclusion, I am still on Tresiba. Again, I started end of November 2020. I really like the flat blood sugar profile that it provides. Given that it doesn't have a peak, I can have those smooth lines throughout the night. I can exercise without seeing any real blood sugar impact. And I kind of like that I can get away with only taking it once a day for the most part. Thank you so much for watching this video on Tresiba and Levemir. This was my experience. I hope this is helpful.